24 Nebraska killers sentenced to life as juveniles should stay locked up.
That's the argument Attorney General Jon Bruning is going to take straight to the Nebraska Supreme Court. KETV News Watch 7's Andrew Ozaki explains.
Convicted of first-degree murder as juveniles and sentenced to life in prison with no chance of parole. Nebraska's Attorney General says these inmates should stay locked up.
These are bad guys. They deserve to be in prison for the remainder of their lives.
But a recent U.S. Supreme Court decision gave these inmates new hope. It ruled states like Nebraska must give judges more options when it comes to juveniles convicted of murder than just life behind bars and throw away the key. So Nebraska was going to do what Iowa did, use its pardon system to review each case and commute those life sentences to a number of years, a lot of years.
I was going to recommend to the board 90 to life or 100 to life without good time law, 90 calendar years.
Public defender Tom Riley represents 14 of the inmates. He argues it should be the Nebraska legislature or the courts that should decide the issue, not the pardons board. And on Friday, he convinced Douglas County District Court Judge Tom Otepka to order a temporary injunction stopping the Nebraska pardons board from hearing the cases. The judge said if the board commutes sentences of 50, 70, or 90 calendar years, it would effectively have done an end run around the Supreme Court decision.
Judge Otepka's ruling, I have no idea what he's talking about. It's a very poor ruling.
Bruning won't speak for the other board members, but says his intentions are clear, trying to protect the public, spare taxpayer money, and court time resentencing all these inmates.
Riley, of course, hopes to get him out early, and that's not my goal. I don't want to see him get out early, and I don't think the public wants to see him get out early just because they were 17 when they committed their crime.
In Lincoln, Andrew Ozaki, KETV, Newswatch 7.
Bruning says that the legislature will have to act on changing state law, but he hopes it will set sentencing times severe enough to reflect the seriousness of the crime.